University of Akron University Libraries.
What is quantitative and qualitative information or research? There are numerous methods in research. In this video, we will categorize research methods as quantitative or qualitative. Essentially, quantitative research involves measuring variables of interest in the research study. Usually, it results in numbers with the associated units of measure, such as a temperature of 25 degrees Celsius or a pressure of 50 kilopascals. Usually, qualitative research involves some interpretation because the information isn't directly measurable. Often, information is categorized. There are practices to quantify qualitative research in order to provide a number, such as coding open-ended survey questions to find the themes that the data suggest. Since interpretation is involved, there is some subjectivity in this type of research. I will provide an example of each. First, let's look at a quantitative study. Let's say I want to prove that Ohm's law is really true. In case you don't know what Ohm's law is, Ohm's law states that the voltage drop of an element in an electrical circuit is equal to the current flowing through the element multiplied by the resistance of the element. The equation is V equals I times R, where V is a voltage in volts, I is a current in amperes, R is resistance in ohms, and the symbol for ohms is the uppercase omega. So in the lab, the positive terminal of the voltage source is connected to the multimeter measuring the current I. Then that ammeter is connected in series with a resistor of 100 ohms. Then that resistor is connected in series with resistor 2, which is 250 ohms, and that's the voltage that I'm interested in. I'm going to put a multimeter measuring the voltage VR2 in parallel with the resistor in order to measure that voltage. Then I'm going to connect resistor 2 to the negative terminal of the voltage source. In my experiment, I measure voltages for the voltage source being 4 to 10, where I increment the voltage by 1 volt each time. And then I have a calculation using the formula for the voltage across the resistor and the current. And then I take a measurement in the lab. Since I'm measuring this voltage, it is quantitative. As an example of qualitative research, a survey was sent to the engineering graduate students to determine what kind of help they needed with their theses and dissertations. There's a table, documentation and writing support for electrical and computer and mechanical engineering graduate student respondents with respect to project phase. It lists some of the questions in this table. So the first question is, have you written a thesis or dissertation prior to this degree? The students can answer yes or they can answer no. This is categorizing students to whether they have written a thesis or dissertation previously. So this is qualitative information. The next two questions, did your advisor give you documentation in addition to instructions from graduate school regarding what your chapter title should be for a thesis or dissertation? And the next question is, did your advisor discuss with you how you should write a literature review or background section? Both of these are yes and no questions. Again, they're qualitative information. The headings on each of the column are choosing a topic, chose topic and doing the work, starting to write, and just finished. This too is a question. It asks the graduate students at what phase they were in their thesis and dissertation research. They have four distinct categories they can pick, so they're being categorized again, so this again is qualitative information. There can be research that use methods that are qualitative and quantitative. This particular article from a research study, polymers additive for improving the flow properties of lubricating oil. First, they use infrared spectroscopy, and they say it's a technique widely used for the analysis of lubricating oils and characterizes various constituents qualitatively. Usually it doesn't tell you directly in the article, so they made it easy for us, but the infrared spectroscopy is qualitative. They also use thermogravimetrical analysis to ensure a relatively simple quantitative interpretation of the results. Again, they tell you what it is. So the thermogravimetrical analysis is a quantitative method.